one day I got into an accident or something happened to my car or something, and he was close by and he's like, oh, why don't you just come to my house and I'll lend you a car. The house was a little bit suspicious. Who lives here? This house like looks half empty. It's kind of weird. He's like, oh, no, no, it's my cousin's house. You know, he still hasn't bought furniture. You know, he needs to do the living room. You know, he just moved in here, blah, blah, blah. So I just walked into one of the rooms, which was the office. He opens up the closet and I see like all these things, like these bricks, you know, rectangular bags, you know, like wrapped in like brown paper from the floor to the ceiling, like all stacked. And I'm like, what is that? Like it was a rectangle. I mean, I'd never ever seen that in my life. And then he like, he slashed it like that. And then I saw what it was. And it was cocaine. I'm like, okay, here. Like, I'm getting out of here. I think maybe he was kind of like testing me and testing the waters. I'm not gonna lie, it's not like he wasn't like the first drug dealer that I went out with. There were other guys that I dated that would come to my house to pick me up, you know, in a $80,000 car. And my parents would be like, okay, you're not going out with him. You know, we're like both doctors and we make out all the money and we don't have that car. I moved in with my mom when my dad passed away. I start dating Peter. My family doesn't want to know about Peter because my mother's always had this thing, well, if you like him that much, he must not be any good. Look who's talking. She's been married and divorced 5 times. So she's like, I don't want to meet him. I don't know what you're doing, but you need to get out of my house. And Peter tells me, why don't you move in with me?